Hello students. So today we are going to discuss about the deadlock. What is the deadlock and what is the certain things that affect on the deadlock? So by the definition, in this before we have already discussed about certain semaphore and we have already discussed about the monitor as well as in the critical section. These are the very important topics that we have already done, but in deadlock situation in operating system, so each process requests some resource, right? So if we want to process any kind of process job, then it requires some certain kind of resources. So here we in the definition we say that each process requests some resources to complete its execution. On other hand, the resources assigned to another process, this situation is known as deadlock. Okay, so ultimately we discuss about certain kind of multiprocessing. Then if process one required some resources, and if this particular resources are give to another process, and the particular process can wait for the same resources, so that kind of situation is all about the representation of deadlock situation. So needs a resource plus utilize the resource and finally release the resource. This is the basic agenda of any kind of process that it is executed in operating system. In any kind of process can be executed in the CPU, right? So there is a main agenda of this particular, that it can resource a need. If suppose to you we want to execute any particular job, then it job requires certain kind of resources as well as, right? So this is all about the, say that deadlock is a condition where each one of the computer process wait for resource which is being assigned to some another process, right? So this is basically a simple conditions where we say that we can wait for certain kind of resources for execution or complete their job. So in this conditions, not only not any of the process get executed while the resources it needs is held by some another process which is also waiting for some other resource be released. That condition is known as a deadlock situation. So we have discussed this particular in lot of ways. That supposed to be we are going to discuss about the deadlock. So deadlock is a situation where a set of process are blocked, right? So in certain points that we collect about the deadlock. So deadlock basically is a situation where a set of process are blocked, basically, right? So because each process is holding a resource and wait for another resource acquired by some other process. Consider, for example, when two trains are coming towards each other, right? And same track, and there is only one track. One of the train can move once they can front of each other. So similar situation occurs in the operating system when there are two or more processes that hold some resources and wait for resources held by others. For example, it's supposed to be the process one holding the resource one and waiting for resource two as well as, which is acquired by the process two, and process is two is waiting for resource one, right? So this is the basic thing that we discuss about the deadlock situation. So every process needs some resource to complete its execution. However, resources granted in the sequential order. The process request for some resources, operating system grant the resources if it is variable available, otherwise latest process waits, right? So the process uses it is release on the completion. So deadlock is a situation where each of the computer process wait for resource which is being assigned for some another process. In this situation, none of the process get executed since this resource it needs held by some another process, which is also wait for some another resources to be released, right? So this is a basic agenda, basic scenario about the deadlock. So in this slide you see that it's supposed to be we have a deadlock conditions over here. So in this P1 required resource R2, but at the same time R2 is assigned to the P2, right? So but P2 at the same time P2 required R3, but R2 is available for the P1. P2, but here P2 is required R3, right? So here what situation is occur, but R3 is reserved for the P3, and also P3 required R1. So this is, basically the condition where we fulfill that deadlock situation occurs over there, right? So here the resource R1 is allocated to the P1, but the P1 required R2. R2 is allocated to the P2, but P2 don't want to use the R2. P2 requires the R3, and R3 also available for the P3, but P3 requires R1. So this is the basic structure about the to understand the deadlock. If we are going to discuss about the essential conditions for the deadlock, then in the first thing that is fulfilled about the deadlock is all about the mutual exclusion, right? So one or more than one resource are none are shareable, right? It means that only one process can use at a time, right? So it means that mutual exclusion is all about that if resource R is available and it can assign only for the P1, right? So this condition is fulfilled, then deadlock can be occurs. Second thing, that essential condition is hold and wait, right? So here the process holding a resource and waiting for additional resource which is held by another process, right? So here we discuss about the R2 and R3. R2 and R3, available for P2 as well as, but at the same time P2 required R1, but R1 is available for P1, but it means that P is reserved hold the R1. But at the same time, P2 hold R2 and R3 as well as. If supposed to be P required R2 and R3, then it can't be available because it hold by the P2. So this is the hold and wait situation over there. And in this, no preemption, right? So a resource cannot be taken from process unless the process release the resource, right? So it can't be taken. It's supposed to be R3 is available for the P3, but at the same time, R2. P3 required R2, but R2 is held by the P2 as well as, right? But P2 hold R2 as well as P, but P2 required R1, but R1 is hold by the P1, right? So this is the preemption condition. If either no process can be executed because each end process required another resources, but another resources are located to the another process. So this is the no preemption is there. No, and after that, there is a fourth one is a circular wait. So, if we are discussing in the earlier that about the basic scenario about the what is the deadlock situation, that if supposed to be any resource is assigned for any kind of process, but a process also P1 is waiting for R2, but as well as resource R2. Is all about assigned to the P2, but at the same time P2 required what it required, it required R3 as well as, and R3 is assigned for P3, but at the same time P3 required R1. So this is all about the circular wait. A set of if suppose we discuss about the set of process about the circular wait, so a set of process are waiting for each other in circular form, right? So if we go for the detailed description about all those things, that what's the mutual exclusion, so there should be a resource that can only be held by one process at a time, right? So this is basically the mutual exclusion, that there should be a resource that can only be held by one process at a time. Supposed to be we have a resource R1 and process P1, right? So it can resource is allocated to the process P1, right? So it means that there is only one resource, and this particular resource is assigned to the process, any kind of process or P1, supposed to be we have considered P1, then the P1. Hold and wait, if we go with hold and wait, then we discuss that a process can hold multiple resource and still request more resource from other processes which are holding them. In diagram, which we have already discussed, that it's supposed to be we have a process 2, then process 2 hold a resource R2 and R3 as well as, but at the same time we say that process P2 is also request for the resource R1 to complete their execution, right? So this is all about what, this is the hold and wait, hold the resource R2 and R3 and waiting for a resource R1 to complete their execution. So this is all about the hold and wait situation. No preemption, a resource cannot be preempted from a process by force, right? So we can't forcefully, we can't permit that it can be preempted from the process by force. If process can only release a resource, vulnerabilities and diagram showing that if process P2 cannot be preempt resource 1 from the process 1. So it will only be released when process 1 relinquish in the voluntarily after its execution is completed. While its execution is completed, then it can release the resources. So this is basically the no preemption, that we are not able to force for the to release the resources for the another process. So if we are going to discuss about the circular wait, so in circular wait, the process is waiting for resource, right, but held by the second process, which is waiting for the resource held by third process, and so on, right? So it means that every process wants to resource, and resources allocated to the another process till the last process is waiting for the request resource held by the first process as well. As this form a circular chain. For example, process 1 is allocated to resource R2 and it is requesting R1. Similarly, process P2 is allocated to R1 and it is requesting R2. This is the basic all about the the situation where we say that circular wait for the deadlock situation, right? So if we go for all the corresponding things that we have already done, that if we go with another definition, because we have a very simple topic and we want to cover in the certain kind of different examples and different definitions, that it is very easy task to easily understand for the purpose. So deadlock is a situation that occur in operating system when any process enter a waiting state because another waiting process is holding the demanded resources. So in this regard, in this definition, we say that deadlock is a situation that occur in operating system, right? So when any process enter in the waiting state, right, because another waiting process is holding the demand resources. So deadlock is a common problem in multiprocessing where several processors share their specific type of mutual exclusive resources known as soft lock or soft cap, right? So with the example, we have more discuss about the deadlock situation. So in this tutorial, if we are going to discuss about the certain operating system, deadlock operating system in operating system, and then we discuss that what is the deadlock with example, what is the example of deadlock in technically as well as in the real world life that we have facing. Okay, so what is the circular wait, deadlock detection, deadlock prevention, deadlock avoidance, how we can avoid the deadlock, difference between starvation and deadlock, advantage of a deadlock, and a certain kind of disadvantage of the deadlock method, right? So certain kind of points which we have covered in this tutorial. For example of the demand deadlock, right? So a real world example would be traffic which is going on one direction. Here the bridge is considered as a resource. When deadlock happened, it can be easily resolved if one car backed up, preempt resource and roll back, right? So this is the thing that we can easily say that in several cars may have to be backed up, and if deadlock situation occurs, so the starvation is possible. Now you see that in this road, if supposed to be there is a one road, one direction bridge is over there. In this bridge there is a certain cars wants to cross, then here there is some problem. It is not possible because there is a no single road over there in the bridge, and it is not possible to cross. First of all, when the one car is crossing, then after the second, and then it is possible. Otherwise, the deadlock situation is occurs, so then no car is cross in this particular bridge. So this is a real world example of the deadlock, to understand the deadlock. So if suppose we are going to discuss about detailed discussion about the circular wait. So in the circular wait, one process is waiting for the resource which is held by a second process, which is also waiting for a resource held by the third process, etc. So this will continue until the last process is get, right? For the resource held by first process, this creates a circular chain. For example, process A is allocated resource B. It is requesting resource A. In the same way, the process B is allocated to resource A, and in it is requesting resource B, just create a circular weight loop, right? So for example of the circular weight is, for example, computer has three USB drives and any and three processes. Each of the three processes able to hold one of the USB drives. So when each process requests another drive, the three process will have the deadlock situation, as each process will be waiting for the USB drive to release, which is currently in use. This will result in a circular chain, right? So like that, USB 1, USB 2, and USB 3. So process 1, process 2, and process 3. So this is the best example of the circular weight and deadlock detection. So deadlock occurrence can be detected by the resource scheduler as well as. A resource scheduler helps operating system to keep track of all the resources which are allocated to different processes. So when a deadlock is detected, it can be resolved using below given methods. A deadlock prevention. If we discuss about the, you know, deadlock prevention, it is important to prevent a deadlock before it can occur. The system checks every transitions before it can execute it to make sure that it does not lead at the deadlock situation, such that even a small change to occur state that an operation which can lead to deadlock in this future, it is also never allowed process to execute. It is a set of method for ensuring about that is at least one of the conditions cannot be hold. So if we are going to more detail about the no preemption action and all. So deadlock detection is, you know, deadlock can be detected by resource scheduler, right? So as it keep track of all the resources that are allocated to different processes, after deadlock is detected, it can be resolved using following methods. There is a certain kind of methods which is used over there. So all the processes that are involved in deadlock are terminated, basically, right? So this is not a good approach, or that all the progress made by the process is destroyed, right? But the thing is that we can deadlock detection is occur there. So resources can be preempted from some processes and given to the other till the deadlock is resolved, right? So this is all about the deadlock detection. And if we discuss about the deadlock prevention, so it is very important to prevent the deadlock before it can occur, right? So the system checks each transition before it execute to make sure it does not lead a deadlock. If there is even slight chance to that transition may lead the deadlock in the future, right? It will never allow to the execute. So deadlock, if we are going to discuss about the deadlock avoidance, so it is better to avoid the deadlock rather than that take measure after the deadlock it occurs. Right, so wait for graph can be used for deadlock avoidance. This, however, only useful for smaller databases, as it can get quite complex in the larger database. Right, so if we say that certain kind of handling, about the that how we can handle the method for handling the deadlock. So there is a certain risk that we can handle, like deadlock prevention or avoidance. We can, the idea that idea is to not let the system into the deadlock state. One thing. Second thing, that deadlock detection and recovery. So first and third one is the deadlock detection, and second one and third one is the ignore the problem altogether, right? So if supposed to be we discuss about the certain handling deadlock method about the deadlock prevention and avoidance, then the idea is not to let the system into the deadlock situation, right? One can zoom into the each category individually, and prevention is done by negating certain one of the above points which we have already discussed. These are the certain kind of things that which we have used for to avoid certain kind of handling situation and all, right? So non-preemption action, non-preemption, a resource can be released only voluntarily by the process holding it after that process has finished its task. If a process which is holding some resources request another resource that cannot be immediately allocated to it, in that situation all the resources will be released. A preempted resource requests the list of the resource for the process that waiting. The process will be restarted only if it can regain its old resources and new one that is requesting. Right? If the process is requesting some other resource than it available, then it was given to the requested process. So if it held the by another process that is waiting for another resource, we release it and give to the requesting process. So if we go with a certain mutual exclusion, it's supposed to be this full form of mutex, right? So if suppose we discuss about it, is a special type of binary semaphore, right? So in semaphore we have already discussed that this is the variable basically, right? It's a variable, and with the help of semaphore, with the counting semaphore and binary semaphore, we resolve the certain kind of critical section problem as well as, right? So in mutual exclusion we discuss about the deadlock, then which used controlling access the shared resources. It includes the priority and inheritance mechanism to avoid the extend priorities, right? Inversion problem and all. So it allows current high priority tasks to be kept in the block state by the shortest time possible. Resource shared such as read-only files never leave the deadlock, but resource like printer and tape drivers needs exclusive access by a single process. So at the same time we discuss about the hold and wait. It can also vary. In this condition, in the hold and wait, then process must be stopped from holding single and multiple resources while simultaneously waiting for one or more other things, right? So circular wait, it imposed a total ordering of all the resource types. Circular wait also required that every process request resource in increasing order of information, right? So deadlock avoidance, so this is basically the handling purpose which we have used. So it is better to avoid deadlock instead of taking action after the deadlock has occurred, right? So it needs additional information like how resource should be used, right? So deadlock avoidance is the simplest and most useful model that each process declare a maximum number of resources of each type of may be needed. It's supposed to be you are provided the resources to a particular process which you have required. So we can easily say that we can avoid from such kind of deadlock situation, right? So it's very simple that we can provide the resources for certain kind of required. It's supposed to be P1 is required, R1, then we can provide the R1 to the P1. So it can, we can easily say that we can avoid from such kind of things like deadlock in the operating system. So avoidance algorithm is also very helpful to avoid from the such kind of hazards in the operating system. Like a deadlock avoidance algorithm help you to dynamically assess the resource allocation state so that there can be never be circular wait situation. A single instance of resource type use the resource allocation stock cycle are necessary, which is sufficient for deadlock. Multiple instance of resources type cycle are necessary but never sufficient for deadlock. Use the Banker's algorithm. Banker's algorithm is also very helpful to avoid such kind of things like we are using for avoidance of the deadlock situation. So if we are going to discuss about the certain difference between the starvation and deadlock. So in the deadlock, deadlock situation occurs when one of the process got blocked, right? But in the starvation case, starvation is a situation where all the low priority process get blocked and high priority process executed. So here the starvation is that lower priority process can be blocked but high priority can be executed. Deadlock is a infinite process, but starvation is a long waiting but not an infinite process, because if a deadlock situation is occurs, then our system is hanged off, right? So but in the starvation problem, here there is some certain time, because lower priority is process wants to execute, but it can take time. After that, sometime if higher priority process are executed, then it can turn over the lower priority process for the execution. So every deadlock always has a starvation, as well as every starvation does not necessarily have a deadlock. So deadlock happen, then mutual exclusion, hold and wait here, preemption and circular wait do not occur simultaneously. But in case of starvation, it happens due to uncontrolled priority and resource management as well. So this is the certain difference between the deadlock and starvation. So after that, if we are going to discuss about the certain kind of advantage of deadlock. So before that advantage, we have certain another things that must be cover up over there in the deadlock situation. Certain things that we have used, there is a certain points which is very essential about to handle that, how we can handle certain kind of things that deadlock ignorance, right? So in deadlock ignorance is most widely used to approach among all the mechanism. This is being used by many operating system mainly for each user uses. In this approach, the operating system assume that deadlock never occurs, right? So this is the conditions where systems can assume that there is no deadlock can occurs. It means that we can ignore the situation. So it is simply ignores deadlock. This approach is best suitable for single and single end user system, where user uses the system only for the browsing and all other normal stuff, right? So this is the deadlock ignorance, and there is always trade-off between the correctness and performance as well as, right? So the operating system like Windows and Linux mainly focus upon the performance. However, the performance of the system decreases if it use deadlock handling mechanism as well as. Right, all the time, deadlock happens one out of 100 times, then it is completely unnecessary to use the deadlock handling mechanism all the time. It's not possible to handle. So in this type of system, the user has to simply restart the computer in case of deadlock Windows and Linux manually using this approach, basically, if the deadlocks can occur. So thing is that. And if we are going to discuss about the deadlock prevention, so deadlock happens only when mutual exclusion, hold and wait, no preemption, and circular wait hold simultaneously, right? All the four conditions are fulfilled simultaneously, then deadlock can be occur. So if it is possible to violate one of the four conditions at any time, then the deadlock can never occur in the system, right? So it's supposed to be in this four conditions like mutual exclusion, hold and wait, no preemption, circular wait, and all. Then it's supposed to be we are able to do the never occur of any kind of situation. Then we say that we can prevent from the deadlock. So the idea behind the approach is very simple, that we can we have to fail one of the four conditions. But there can be big argument on its physical implementation in the system. So it is very detailed description. So we will discuss it in later section, that how we can deadlock prevent from the deadlock situation. So deadlock avoidance. So deadlock avoidance in the operating system, checks whether the system is safe state or in the unsafe state at every step which is operating system perform the process contests until the system is in safe state or not, right? Once the system moves or unsafe state, the operating system has to backtrack one step. In simple words, the operating system reviews each allocation so that the allocation does not cause the deadlock in the system. So we will discuss also, we can discuss it in the later section, that what is the how we can avoid such kind of thing. Now after that, there is a fourth one point, that is the deadlock detection and recovery. So this approach let the process fall in the deadlock and periodically checks whether the deadlock occurs in the system or not. If not it occurs, then it applies some of the recovery methods to the system to get rid of deadlock. Okay, This is the all about certain points that is very important before that we are going to discuss about the advantage and disadvantage of deadlock, right? So if we are going to discuss about the certain advantage, what is the certain advantage? Here there are the benefits by using deadlock method. Situation works well for process which performs single burst of activity. If supposed to be there is a single burst of activity, then it's very beneficial. No preemption need for the deadlock. In deadlock, there is no preemption needed. Convenient method when applied to resources whose state can be saved and restored easily, right? So it is convenient. Feasible to enforce via complete time checks. Needs no runtime computation since the problem is solved in the system design. So this is basically the certain kind of advantage. And if we discuss about the disadvantage, if we are going to discuss about the certain disadvantage of particular deadlock, so here there is a drawback of using deadlock method. Delay process initiation. Process must know future resource need preempts more than necessary. Disallows incremental resource requests. Inherit preemption losses. So these are the certain disadvantage if we are going and if we are working on the same situation, then we can do the same. So now there is a certain summary. If supposed to be we are going to discuss about certain points that we have discussed in a detailed section, as well as we can define things. So if we define with the deadlock is a definition, then it is a situation that occurs in the operating system when any process enters a waiting state, because another waiting process holds the demanded right resources at the same time. Circular waiting happens when one process is waiting for resources which is held by the second process, which is also waiting for the resources held by the third process as well as, right? So in the beginning of this particular video, we have already discussed that how the circular wait is work. Okay, so we will in this revising class, we will also check it out that how the system is going to be hold and wait situation is occurs and what is the circular waiting is over there. A deadlock occurrence can be detected by the resource scheduler. It is important to prevent a deadlock before it can be occurs, right? So this is very important point over here, that if it is very important to prevent the deadlock before it can be occurs. A resource can be released only voluntarily by the process holding it after that process has finished its task, right? So mutual exclusion is a full form of mutex. Mutual exclusion. In mutual exclusion, we have already discussed in the critical section that mutual exclusion provides us the facility to enter any kind of process in the critical section for execution only one, not more than one, right? So this is all about the mutual exclusion. So it is a special type of binary semaphore which is used for controlling access to shared resource. Hold and wait is condition where the process must be stopped from holding single or multiple resource while simultaneously waiting for one or more other. Deadlock avoidance is the simplest and most useful model that each process declared a maximum number of resource for of each type that it may needs. So deadlock avoidance algorithm help you to dynamically for the same. Deadlock is an infinite process where the starvation a long waiting but not an infinite process, right? So this is basically the summary of the deadlock in the operating system. And now there is a certain MCQ, so it can also help us to revise our topic. So in this MCQs, we say that the wait for graph is a deadlock detection algorithm that is applicable when all the resources have a single instance, all resources have multiple instance, all resources have a seven multiple instance, all of the above. So here the right answer is the A. So it means that the wait for graph is a deadlock detection algorithm that is applicable when all resources have a single instance. If all the resources have a single instance, then we can applicable for the algorithm, right? So if wait for graph contains its cycle then a deadlock does not exist, then deadlock exists, then system is in safe state. Either deadlock exists or system is in safe state. So B is the right answer, that if wait for the graph contains a cycle, then the deadlock exists. Another MCQ that provides us the result about the deadlock. So if deadlock occurs frequently, the detection algorithm must be invoked. Really frequently, really and frequently, none of the above. So B is the frequently. If it is very simple from that, if deadlock occurs frequently, then you know the detection algorithm also must be invoked frequently as well as, so directly proportional, right? So wait, what is the disadvantage of invoking the detection algorithm? If we are going to discuss about certain points that is very important about what is the disadvantage of invoking the detection. So overhead of detection algorithm due to consumption of memory, excessive time consumed in the request to be allocated memory, considerable overhead and computation time, all of the above mentioned. C is the right answer, that what is the disadvantage of invoking the detection algorithm for every request? So considerable overhead in computation time. So another MCQ is all about the deadlock eventually crypt system throughput, and which caused the CPU utilization to dash. B is the right answer. It means that drop. Another, every time a request for allocation cannot be granted immediately, the detection algorithm is invoked. This will help identify what dash. So set of processes that have been deadlocked, the set of processes in the deadlock queue, the specific process that caused the deadlock, all of the mentioned. So A is the right answer, that every time the request for allocation cannot be granted immediately, the detection algorithm is invoked. This will help identify the set of processes that have been deadlocked, right? So it can also used. Now a system has three processes sharing four resources. Each process needs a maximum of 2 units. Then deadlock can never occur, may occur, has to occur, none of the above. Okay, so A is the right answer, that can never occur, right? So it's supposed to be, we have a three process and we have a four resources, then deadlock is very minimum chances, or we can say that it can never occur. So another MCQ is that deadlock situation can arise if which of the following condition holds simultaneously in a system: mutual exclusion, hold and wait, non-preemption and all. So we have already done that in all the conditions like mutual exclusion, hold and wait, non-preemption is occurs, then we can say that deadlock situation is occurs. If we can fail any kind of situation, then we can avoid from such kind of things, right? So thanks student. This is all about the deadlock, and if we are going to revise our complete revision of deadlock one by one. So in the definition we have discussed each process requires some resource to complete its execution. On the other hand, the resource is assigned to another process, right? So in this situation known as deadlock. So very simple, if very logically things that we have considered, that if a process is going on and if process required a resource, but resource is not available for the same process, so things happen, that is thing is known as all about the deadlock. So need a resource, utilize the resource, and finally release the resource. This is the basic flow of any kind of process, that it can't be it can be executed in our CPU. But if supposed to be there is some problem, certain kind of problem like a mutual exclusion, hold and wait, preemption, non-preemption and all, then we can say that we can it can create the deadlock. So deadlock is a condition where each one of the computer process wait for the resource which is being assigned to some another process, right? So in this conditions, not only the process gets executed while the resource it needs held and for some process, right? So here you see that if R1 is basically assigned to the P1, but at the same time P1 required R resource too, but at the same time R2 is assigned to the P2, but P2 required R3 as well as, and R3 is assigned to the P3, but at the same time P3 you know required R1. So it means that there is a certain hold and wait condition over there, all right? So this kind of situation is all about the deadlock. So if we are going to discuss about the mutual exclusion, then we have already discussed that in the details, that mutual exclusion is all about that resource is allocated to the process. So you know, if resource is allocated to the process, then we can it means that there is a not availability of the resources. Hold and wait, so process holding a resource and waiting for additional resource which held by another process, right? So this is also basically, you know, hold and wait, because at the same time we discuss here that process P2 hold R2 and R3, but at the same time P2 also wait for R1, but at the same time R1 is assigned to the P1, means that P is also you know hold you know R1 as well as. So such kind of hold and wait condition is there. No preemption means that it means that we cannot forcefully release any kind of you know resources for process, right? So R3 is assigned to P3, but P3 required R2 as well as, but R2 is assigned to the P2, but P2 is resource P2 process required to R1 as well as, but R1 is allocated to P1 as well as. If supposed to be P1 is over there, but P1 also required a R3 as well as resource, but R3 is you know allocated to the P3. So this is basically the situation where we can say that it can also helpful to you know create a deadlock situation. Circular wait also define that R1 is you know assigned to the P1, but P1 required R2. R2 required you know R2 is assigned for P2 as well as, but P2 you know required R3 as well as, and R3 you know assigned to the P3, but P3 you know required R1. So this is all about the circular wait. And also we have done you know in the deadlock is a situation that occurs in the operating system. Any process enters in the waiting state because another waiting process is holding the demand, right? And there is a certain point that we have discussed in the real world example. This is the you know normal flow of the traffic, but here there is a bridge, and bridge only passes one way, you know, traffic. Then it's supposed to be, it can go for the side road, then it can easily you know pass, but otherwise it can create a deadlock situation and no car will be passed over the bridge, right? So what is the circular wait? So one process is waiting for another resource which is held by the second process, which is also waiting for the resource, right? So this is all about, so here circular wait example, that if supposed to be we have a multiple USB, USB 1, USB 2, USB 3, and we can you know process required USB 2, but USB 2 hold by the process 2, and process 2 demand you know for the USB 3 as well as. So this kind of you know circular wait. Deadlock detection. In the deadlock you know detection, we have deadlock occurrence can be detected by a resource scheduler as well as a resource scheduler help the operating system. Also there is a certain kind of prevention. No preemption occurs, mutual exclusion, hold and wait. In this condition, you know, process must be stopped from holding single or multiple resources while simultaneously waiting for one or more other. So circular wait is also imposed the total ordering, deadlock avoidance. So it is better to avoid the deadlock instead of taking action after the deadlock has occurred. It is it needs additional information like that. Okay, avoidance of algorithm. So deadlock avoidance algorithm also you know help to you dynamically access the resource allocation system so that there can never be circulated with the situation over there. After that we have discussed the difference between the deadlock and the starvation. So in the deadlock, deadlock situation occurs when one of the process got blocked. But in the starvation, you know, starvation is a situation where all the low priority process, you know, got blocked, and high priority process executes, right? So deadlock is an infinite process, and the starvation is long waiting process as well as, right? So there is a certain difference between both of them. And after that, we have discussed about the advantage. If we are going to discuss a certain kind of advantage, you know, the situation will work well for the process which perform a single burst of activity, no preemption needed for the deadlock, convenient method when applied for the resource and all. So this is the certain disadvantages also available. Delay process must know the future resources, preempts more than necessity, right? So this allows the incremental resources request, inherent certain kind of things like that. And after that, we have done the summary and certain MCQs, right? So thank you very much for